to me. It seems you've lost your shame, your steam. It seems you've lost it, demons haunt your thinking. Freedom gone and all exhausted, exhausted, dreaming dreams of fortune. All your deeds are all in prompt and not in sync with laws and warnings never heeded. Why you blot them, marching forth and choosing what to keep and leave consistently. You're falling all or nothing, please, I'll tweak it out. I think I'm on to something.
I'm Richie Flores. I represent the National Federation of Blind here in Austin. I do a lot of the youth program.
All right, I'm out here from coming from Fort Worth. My name is Dennis. I've been playing b-ball for about 3 years. I'm just a rookie, and I'm just trying to come out here and have a good time.
My name is Dwayne Sparks, known as the U-Haul in beat baseball. And I've been associated with the sport since 1986.
Hi, my name is Lupe Perez. I've been playing baseball, beat baseball, since 92.
My name is Jose Gear. I'm president of the SFA Beat Baseball Club, and I have been playing beat baseball since my freshman year of college, which is fall 2010.
My name is Drew Burnett. This is going to be my fifth summer playing beat ball. It'll be my fourth World Series that I'm going to go to. And I love it.
My name is Molly Fleming, and I'm a volunteer for the Austin Black Bulls. I'm also a spotter.
My name is David Robert. I'm with the Stephen F. Austin University Lumberjacks. I'm the pitcher of the team. I've been with the team for 5 years now.
I'm Jonathan Fleming. I'm the head coach of the Austin Blackhawks.
My name is Monica Villarreal, and I am the president of the Disability Advocacy Student Coalition at the University of Texas at Austin.
My name is Bill Brown. Blind people call me Barbecue Bill.
Really happy to have a baseball weekend spring training here for in Austin. We're really excited to have some folks from College Station. They have a new team called the Outlaws there. We have Stephen F. Austin University here, and some of our players here on the Austin Blackhawks. So we're really excited, and it's going to be a fun day.
I'm captain of the Roadrunners up there in Dallas, and then this year I've been helping out with SFA. I go to school out there, kind of helping get the club team up there out and going a little bit more.
The Brazos Valley Center for Independent Living actually got a health and fitness grant that helped us purchase equipment, so it's been a really good partnership with them, and we're just delighted to be able to bring the sport to College Station and hopefully get more and more people involved.
Beatball is an incredible sport. It gives us a chance to compete, build lifetime friendships.
I first originally got in because, you know, friends said, hey, come on out here, you know, this will be fun. So
I came out a few years ago to something similar to this and asked if I could come out and help them practice. And next thing I know, I was out every Sunday helping and basically got hooked. I enjoyed the people I was practicing with.
I started volunteering about a year ago.
I really enjoy the players and the sport itself. It's about as pure a sport as I've ever seen. I mean, they really play from their hearts. So it's really awesome. Yeah.
Kind of fun and interesting, and it's just a really fun game to play and watch. Super fun to watch.
It's highly competitive, and it's very athletic, and it's just an amazing sport that I hope more and more people get involved with, blind and sighted.
It's a very interesting sport. It's different from a lot of other sports that are more set and founded. It has its own little style, but I love it. It's a lot of fun.
Oh, it's just a blast. It's good competition, you know. Honestly, like, the people in it are amazing. It's really nice because you see like a higher level of independence in everyone that goes out there. It's definitely not a sport for couch sitters and stuff. And so it's good company, good competition, you know, just all around good time.
It's the first competitive sport, or it's the first sport period that I played, and it's a lot of fun. I mean, when I went blind, I didn't think I could play anything, but once I found this, I was like, I'm actually good at it.
It's always been a good thing for me. I love playing sports. I'm very competitive. I like to work out, so it's a pretty good workout, pretty good exercise for me. And it's very beneficial because, shoot, I get to run. Run without a cane is the coolest feeling ever, man.
Ever since we started with the organization, I've been in contact with people from beat baseball, and we've organized different tournaments over the past 2 years here at the field. And I think it's a really cool thing to bring in both sighted and non-sighted people together, a community activity that brings in everyone participates in some aspect.
I got involved with it because I'm retired from AT&T, and they're the ones that actually, the pioneers invented the ball, and that's how I got involved with it. And just to, you know, I like barbecuing, and it worked out pretty good. I have sausage, chicken, hot dogs, and pork sandwiches, potato salad and beans, iced tea, lemonade, and bottled water.
Biggest thing about Beach Baseball is being committed. If you're not committed, you're not going to get to the ultimate goal, which is the championship. Commitment, discipline are the two easiest things in any other sport that you can name of or you can think of that's going to get you to the top.
A couple people we want to thank for making this all happen. First of all, it's the University of Texas and their Disability Advocacy Student Coalition for letting us come out here and use the intramural fields. And we also want to thank the Telecom Pioneers, who's an official volunteer for Beat Baseball. Sports Vision 2020 raises awareness for adaptive sports here in Austin. And also the National Federation of the Blind, who always tries to come up with interesting ways for people to get together and become empowered through any means. So we thank them. We also remind anybody who wants to read the sports page, and you're blind or print disabled, go read NFB Newsline.
We're here to teach new players how to play a beat baseball game at a university level. You know, a lot of these kids, they go to college and they're told not to be athletes, they can't be athletes, they're visually impaired, they have no chance at that. What we're doing is we're trying to get a chance for these kids to get an education at a good university and be called athletes for the first time in their lives for some of these people, and a lot of them just becoming athletes again. And that's our mission, that's our goal, and we're going to do it for years to come.